Class 10 children, good morning. Yesterday we have seen the introductory part of banking, money and credit, the third chapter. Now we are going to see the second revision part from the same chapter, that is nothing but the issuing authority of currency. Issuing authority of currency. Already we studied. So, this is a revision time for us for the PT1. Okay, who is the issuing authority of our currency? See, all coins plus 1 rupee note will be issued by the Ministry of Finance. You studied, no? Then, other than 1 rupee note, all currencies be issued by the Reserve Bank of India or Central Bank. Very important question. So, where is the headquarters of the RBI? It's in Mumbai. The next thing is the column. What we are going to see, this is the types of deposits. Next heading, what we are going to revise, types of deposit. Usually, we can divide the deposits into two heads. One is the time or the term deposits. Second one is the demand. In that way only we studied, no? Demand deposits. So, in the time or term deposit, it says, VRL, the banks are given time or term for the maturity of the deposits. Time or deposits for the maturity of the deposits. What kind of deposits are coming under this category? One is the fixed deposit. Second one is the recurring deposit. These are because we are all giving time or term for the maturity of the deposit. That's why these two accounts are coming under the term deposit or the time deposit. Come to the demand deposit. What is the meaning of it? If demand happens, immediately we can use, which are the things? A check, ATM card or withdrawal slip in order to withdraw the money from our account. So, that's why that account, that deposit is called as a demand deposit. So, what are the accounts are coming under the demand deposit? Children, if you use the ATM cards, on the screen, what type of accounts are coming under? One is the current account. Second one is the savings account. These two are coming under the demand deposit. A demand happens, any emergency happens, we are all withdrawing the amount from our account. So that's why these two are coming under the demand deposit. Current account is favorable for the business people as well as the industrial. Saving account is favorable for the monthly income people, in that way we have seen. So, next one is the loan activities of the banks. What they are all doing? Loan activities of the banks. What they are all doing? See, before we are going to the loan activities of the bank, we have to see the functions of the commercial banks or the nationalized banks. What they are all doing? One side, they are accepting the deposits from the public. In that way, they are accepting the deposits from the public. So, time deposit, demand deposit. And other way, the same amount will be given as the loans and advances to the needy people. So, one side they are all receiving the deposit, other side they are all given the loans and advances to the needy people. Okay. See, for the deposits, they are all given the minimum rate of interest. For the giving of the loans, lending the loans to the people, to the public, they are all getting more interest rate compared to the deposit holders. So, in the mean gap, banks are living, that is a main profit for the banks to run. Is it clear? Okay, these are all the things. Okay, tomorrow we will see the next revision part. Study well. Thank you.